Since Like Minds was an Australian-UK co-production, it was really important to get the mix right. Since I'd already cast Tony Collette and Richard Roxburgh out of Australia, I had to travel up to the UK to start casting for the boys.
A simple game.
Lucy Bevan, my casting director, suggested I should see this young theatre actor called Eddie Redmond. So she brought him in and I threw him into the mix with all the different actors that I'd been testing. And it was when I put him with Tom Sturridge that everything kind of just fell into place. It was this incredible dynamic between the two of them that was evident in the first 10 seconds of the screen test, which was exactly what I was looking for.
You feel it.
It's my first film. It's kind of a steep learning curve. Here, there are several times in this film where the character is completely emotionally wrenched. You have to start the scene dry, as it were, and then have your breakdown, and then cut, wipe away the tears, and start all over again. I argue with Tom Sturridge, who plays Nigel, about what the film's about, because whereas I contest, it's about my character, Alex, who is the son of the headmaster and is going through this like tumultuous period of adolescence. Tommy always suggests that it's his film, and in fact it's all about Nigel.
It's been great working with Ed. I've never really done a project which I've spent so much time on, and I've spent a lot of time with him, so we've grown very close, and it's been a great experience. We spent 2 months in Australia and we've spent a month in England, and so we've sort of really, really had a good time.
There is a chemistry between them which is there in real life. They're great buddies, and the fact that Eddie and Tom have a connection in real life is enormously helpful. You can see that chemistry. It's a pact. There's a meeting definitely of minds between the two of them in real life as much as there is on the screen.
And then Toni Collette, who plays the psychologist, is a phenomenal actress and quite an amazing woman. You never really know that she's in films because she's so different in all of them. She's staggering. In the same way that Richard Roxburgh, I mean, if you compare like Moulin Rouge, in which he plays the Duke, to Van Helsing, I mean, you just do not recognise the lad. And that's what's been such a thrill, is there's such comedians.
Tom and I are rehearsing a moment when I have to smack the shit out of him, basically, which is quite fun, but we have to get it right so that he, as much as I would like him to end with a blood streaming down his nose, I don't think he's so...
That's it, you're just going to say, I'm going to hit him, bang.
That's getting... There was rumour of a rain machine, but actually it's been provided courtesy of God.
It's quite intense, gritty. Places we're shooting in and around Yorkshire have been the schools that we're using are so steeped in history themselves that it's great because it kind of throws it all on you and you begin to invest in it.
Today is the quiet confrontation that happens between my character and Eddie's character, when my character kind of catches Eddie's character, Alex, in a lie and starts to suspect.
That's it.
I think that was it.
That's weird.
And I have a sort of deep guilt about meeting him, so I kind of have to, I'm doing my best to kind of not really engage with him, but he kind of sees straight through me.
What do you think about that?